If you watched some of my previous videos, then you noticed that I have some icons of spells on my screen. Lot of people ask me in comment section, please share your weak auras. But there is only one problem. I don't use weak auras. That is actually done by one addon. Very good addon in my opinion, which is called TellMeWhen. This addon that provides visual notification about cooldowns, buffs and pretty much every other element of combat. This video will cover basics of this addon with some examples of use for several classes. So let's begin. Like every other addon, you have to download it and put it inside interface addons folder. Link is in the description of the video. After you've done that, only thing left is to enable it inside login screen. When you log in for the first time, on your screen you can see several 4-slot empty action bars. You can move them, resize them and etc. There are only two commands which you need to use. /tmw enable or /tmw disable. If you wanna edit your bars, just write again same command. So, for example, on first login you see them empty. Then you use /tmw enable, all bars disappear. Once again, same command and they appear so you can edit your bars. If you wanna hide some of the icon groups, then use command /tmw options. And there you can show or hide different icon groups and even increase columns and rows of each icon group. Each icon group is separated and you can expand columns and rows up to maximum of 7 columns per 7 rows. Multiply that by 8 icon groups is total of 392 icons, which this addon gives to you. More than enough, right? Now I will show you some examples of usage which I personally use. The simplest one is about cooldowns of your class. For example, you play Warrior and two best DPS opener cooldowns are Recklessness and Deathwish. For longer boss fights when you need to pop up your cooldowns multiple times. To do that, just write names of those abilities into each bar, enable them, in icon type pick cooldown, and that's it. You can also choose whether you want this icon to be shown when it's usable, unusable or always. I choose that my icon are shown when they are usable. Once I use them, they disappear from my screen. To demonstrate this, let's first use both spells. They disappear from the screen. Speed up a bit and once their cooldown is done, then they both appear on screen. Second icon type is buff or debuff. For example, you are hardcore raider and before each boss you want to have all buffs. So you can make every single buff or just some important paladin buffs as an icon. And when someone buffs you, that icon appears or disappears. To do that, you need to enter name of buff which you wanna see in icon. Enable that icon, select icon type as buff debuff, select that it is a buff, you need to watch player, shown when this buff is present or absent. To demonstrate this, I joined into random VOA and once paladin starts to buff me, my icons pop up. Another thing which is kinda useful for warrior in particular is your talent procs. In Fury specialization you got talent Blood Surge, which gives your slam an instant cast. If you even have 4 out of 5 pieces of your set, then you could get even 2 instant casts of slam instead of just one. You just need to know the name of buff which you get when your talent procs. And after that you repeat all that just like for paladin buffs, which we did a moment ago. To demonstrate this, let's use the target dummy and not only that our icon show, it also show how many stacks of instant slams we got and how much time we got left to use it. That's something addon cheese doesn't show you. Last thing about Warrior and this addon is using it as debuff. Sometimes you need to stack spell Thunder Armor on boss, and to do that it's mostly the same as buff, only thing you select that it's debuff and that you need to watch is target and not player. To demonstrate this, we go again to target dummy and start to cast the spell. We also see the timer and how many stacks is actually on our target. Now about what spells to put into these icon bars. For Warrior, I kinda showed all, more or less. For Warlock spells like Curse of Agony, Corruption, Emulate, or even Glyph of Mana Tap for more spell power. Or for Demonology lock, when you can cast Soulfire for free with also a timer so you don't lose any soul shards. Then for Assassination Rogue, your two most important abilities, which are Hunger for Blood and Slice and Dice. Or for Shadow Priest, your dots on your target or maybe some healing cooldowns. The list goes on. All depends what you play and what cooldowns you wanna see. Most important thing when using this addon is writing name or spell, buff or debuff, exactly like it is. If you just miss one letter, that icon won't work. Trust me, I had small problems when I started to use this addon. Few things to mention before the end of this video. I gave gold to all winners of my third giveaway. In the last video, one player from Onyxia received 1k gold, but the other one sent me in-game mail that he have a lot of obligations and exams, so he cannot play much, and if I can send him gold with mail. So that's exactly what I did. On Icecrown, both winners reached to me in comment section and in-game, so I trade both player their 100k gold each. Only this guy Janalis chose some strange place with some strange sounds, so keep an eye on him. Congrats again to all winners. Also, there is a link of Discord server in video description. Feel free to join. I'm still working on making this server full with useful informations, so bear with me. It will take me some time to make this place a hangout for all Warmane gold farmers. Thanks for watching. Like, share, consider subscribe, and see you again in some other in-game tips video.